Planet Dolan.
From the most dangerous domesticated animal to whether you can survive without bones, we answer several of your most peculiar questions about life. My name is Melissa, and I'll be reading out the questions and answers.
Ooh! Guess what, everybody? It's your favorite hunk of man. It's me, Nixium, and I'm here to reveal to all of you mortals the truth of all things.
Rapid Thrash asks, if I fell down a hole to the core of the earth, would I stop falling when I reach the center?
If you fall into the deep pits of the earth, you must beware, as there are foul things that lurk below. All who travel too deep beneath the surface never return.
Lighten up, Nixium. That seems a little gloomy. We're here to entertain people, not scare them.
Okay, fine. I neglected to mention that these foul creatures look like teddy bears. They are horrendously cute. Here, Melissa, I got you one as a gift.
Oh, Nixium, that's so sweet of you. It's, adorable.
I knew you would like it.
If such a thing were possible, and there was a hole going from one side of the Earth to the other, gravity would pull you towards the center, with your velocity increasing as you fall. Once you reach the center, you would become completely weightless. However, due to the velocity you are now traveling at, you would pass straight through and eventually emerge on the other side of the planet. Nabs asks, what's the most dangerous animal that has been successfully domesticated?
The most dangerous beast to be tamed by me was the ferocious unicorn. And now it is my noble steed. Behold!
Oh my, it's beautiful, Nixium.
I am the harbinger of your demise.
That's a good boy.
A domesticated animal has either been trained or adapted to live in a human environment, which means most only require mild caution. Some of these animals include dogs, buffalo, horses, and camels. Semi-domesticated pets become far more dangerous. These include large cats like cheetahs and tigers, but also large reptiles and birds such as alligators and ostriches. Chief Surgeon asks, do we have the technology to teleport an object or living creature?
Melissa, aren't you working on a teleportal thing?
Yeah, but it's far from finished. There's a lot of problems when it comes to—
Oh yeah! Let's try it out!
No, Nixium, wait!
Whoa. Damn. Even as a woman, I still look good.
You're going back through that teleporter. Right now, we do not have the technology to teleport an object or a living creature. Recently, however, a team of Chinese scientists were able to beam the quantum state of a photon from Tibet to a satellite in orbit. While we're a long way from teleporting a person, this was considered a huge breakthrough. Storymaker asks, why are some animals cold-blooded? Nixium, are you technically cold-blooded?
Excuse me? My blood might be dried up, but I have the warmest heart of any elf. And I'll prove it! Melissa, babe, accept this trophy as a token of my undying affection.
Oh, Nixium, you shouldn't have. Really, there are different ways in which animals regulate their temperature. Cold-blooded animals, which include most reptiles, fish, and amphibians, are called ectotherms. They take advantage of external conditions to raise their body temperature, like sunlight. This is the opposite of warm-blooded animals, known as endotherms, which metabolize fats and sugars to generate internal heat. Jason Lewis asks, what would happen if the oceans and sky turned green?
A green sky is a sign that your world is poisoned. You must flee your doomed planets before it's too late. Although, many would say that it is humans who are the poison of worlds.
Do you have something against humans, Nixium?
Humans invaded my homeland. Then, they built fast food restaurants all over the place.
So you hate humans because they took over your home?
What? No. They won it fairly by right of conquest. It's just, this fast food service stinks. I said
I wanted a cheeseburger with large fries.
What's that, my lord? You say you want some nuggets?
No! I said I want a cheeseburger with large fries!
All right, my lord. There's one large box of Griffin Nuggets coming right up.
The sky and oceans appear blue because the longer wavelengths of light, red, orange, and yellow, are absorbed more strongly by the water and atmosphere. If the sky appears green, it could be a sign that severe weather is approaching, like a tornado. This could be caused by water droplets in the air, which scatter light under certain conditions, making the sky appear green. Cicely Quivum asks, why is the Earth's core lava?
The Earth's core is not lava. It's a great forge created by the dwarves of old. From it, they shaped the planet, building mountains and valleys with my help.
If that's true, then where are they now?
Oh, that's simple. There was no money in it. They'd spend ages crafting a mountain and then nobody would buy it. Nowadays, most dwarves work in insurance. Don't tell anybody this, Melissa, but I've claimed life insurance 5 times already. They have no rules against undead beings. Idiots.
The core of the Earth isn't actually lava. Both the inner and outer core are made of an iron-nickel alloy, with the inner core being solid and the outer core being liquid. Lava is magma that reaches the surface of our planet, and magma is composed of molten rock that forms in the mantle below the Earth's crust. Clash Royale fan asks, is it possible to taste food without saliva?
All great elves have the ability to taste objects simply by making contact with them. Just watch! Damn. That's delicious. Oh god! That's foul! Oh.
The taste buds on your tongue require a liquid medium for you to experience the flavors of food. If your tongue was completely dry, your ability to taste would be diminished. Saliva is also helpful for breaking down sugars and other carbohydrates. Additionally, saliva helps to keep your mouth healthy and your breath smelling good. Nixium, if you're undead, does your body produce saliva?
Nah, my mouth is as dry as a desert. Check it out.
Fireheart asks, what would happen if every cat on Earth died?
Then there would be more minions for the army of the dead. Skeletons need company too, you know.
I don't think people would appreciate their pets being turned into skeletal monsters.
Shows what you know. Ain't that right, Snookums? Yeah, it's my kitty.
Cats may seem dependent on us for food and care, but the truth is they are capable hunters. Studies have suggested that in the US alone, cats are estimated to kill up to 4 billion birds, as well as 6.3 to 22.3 billion mammals. If every cat suddenly died, the rodent population would wildly increase, which would be disastrous for farming and would have tremendous ecological effects. Would you survive if you slept in a fridge overnight?
A fridge? That's nothing. To preserve my beautiful body, I sleep in a freezer. Well, not quite sleep, more like stand quietly.
What do you do to pass the time if you don't sleep?
Oh, I do what everybody else does when they can't sleep. I think for hours about things that upset me. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm looking good. Nice. Ah!
You look ridiculous.
The ideal temperature for a fridge is about 4 degrees Celsius or 40 degrees Fahrenheit. With the right clothing, the temperature in the fridge would not be a problem. What will be a problem, however, is your oxygen supply, since you would suffocate within a few hours inside an average-sized sealed fridge. 123 Michelo asks, can you survive without bones?
That is ridiculous!
Really? You talk about skeletons and undead all the time.
That's different, Melissa. You can't survive as a blob.
Ahem. I beg to differ.
Oh, Dolan. I just thought you were a fat skeleton.
That's an oxymoron, Nixium.
Did you just call me a moron? I'm not gonna stay here and be insulted. Come, my noble steed. Let's go.
Nixium, please come back. Don't go.
Without a skeleton to protect your vital organs, any minor impact could be fatal. And without bones supporting your body, you would not be able to breathe, move, or eat. On top of that, bone marrow also creates most of the body's blood. Without it, you would lack the necessary blood cells to transport oxygen to the brain. Basically, you're going to need bones to survive.
Can you believe the nerve of those two? Calling me a moron?
They just don't appreciate the vast amount of wisdom I have to share. But they'll learn. Anyway, kinda hungry. Oh yeah, now that's some good pie.
This video was made possible by our fans over on Patreon. Thanks for your support, guys. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a good one!